Hello, everybody, and welcome back once again. Here we are with another edition of Inside the Headset on Wednesday night, and we're at our last stop. But we've added a new face, a new coach, and this coach is hot, you all. He's up in Kentucky and just outside of Lexington over Madison County, which is the second biggest county in the state of Kentucky. And kind of the little stepbrother is, if you want to go down the deal, is it's Madison Central, Madison Southern, and then there's Berea, and that's the head coach Aaron Stepp, and that's who we're going to talk to, the Pirate head coach Aaron Stepp. How you doing tonight, Coach?
Doing real good, Stork. How you doing? You doing good things tonight? I heard a lot of your show and really impressed with some of those coaches out there and really enlightened by some of the things those guys are saying. You know, that's pretty informative for me. It's always good to hear from, especially from coaches.
Hello? Are you there, Coach?
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Okay. Go, repeat that, please, so that our fans can hear it. Sorry.
Your show, and I said it's been really, really entertaining. I said it's always good to be a coach from one state and listen to coaches from another state.
Well, we and a lot of like you said, in differentiators, you know, we go from 3A and then we talk to the private sector, and then we go, right to Memphis, and then we stay around here in Murfreesboro, and then we go down to Alabama. But I'm fortunate, Coach, and all those guys are just a lot of fun and a lot of many years. When you add it up, the guy just got off the phone with Coach Maynard. He's got 40 years. So just a lot of experience. And, you know, when we get in this circle, this Wednesday night circle of what I call it, it's a fraternity of coaches that want to talk, and, you know, they want to talk about their team, and I try to give them their time, and we just have a real good time with it and everything. But let's get into you and talk. Tell us a little bit about Coach Stepp and how you got in the sport and where you played high school football and where you thought that you needed to pick up a whistle and become a coach, and then kind of take us back around to how you landed at Berea and kind of educate the fans on what you're trying to do.
Well, this is my second go around at Berea. Actually, I was here about 21 years ago. You know, I was actually my first head coach in Stepp. Was at Berea, and I'm always Kentucky boy. I'm from the mountains of Kentucky, a little town there, Martin County, Kentucky. A little town called Lovely, Kentucky, is where I'm from. And
Did you play football at Martin County?
Well, no, I did. Yes, sir. I played at Sheldon Clark High School.
Okay, Sheldon Clark. That helps me. Now I know Sheldon Clark. Keep going.
No. Then my family, we moved over to Prestonsburg, and ended up, I graduated, played my junior and senior at Prestonsburg High School.
In Floyd County?
Yes, sir, in Floyd County.
And that's not too far. You was not real far from where King Kelly played and where he grew up.
That's right. He was from Wayland.
Okay.
Which is right there, actually right there in the same area. Of course, you're talking way back in the day then.
My
dad actually got to watch King Kelly Coleman play.
Really?
Gives you an idea.
Wow. Man, he was something. I try to tell people, King Kelly. But go on. All right, so I know where you are. Take us around. Keep us coming.
Well, anyway, so I guess the short version is, played a little college ball. Actually played a little bit there at Maryville in Tennessee.
Really? And, so you played D3 ball?
Yeah, played a little ball at Maryville.
Okay. And you say it right. You know what? And you say it right. The funny thing is, you say it right. Nobody else knows how. They'll say Maryville, and you say it just like we all say. It's Maryville. Yeah.
Well, you got to understand something now. I'm from East Kentucky, so we don't know how to enunciate. We just go ahead and call it what it is.
Okay. Go ahead. That's great, Coach Stepp. Keep coming.
That's like around here is a little town down the road called Barberville.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know where that's at. I know where Barville is.
Yeah.
But I don't know about no Barberville. That ain't in Kentucky.
Go ahead, Coach. I'm loving it. Keep us coming.
But no, that's like I said, Bree is my first head coaching job. I've been coaching for 24 years. Head coach 17 years, but like I said, first job was at Berea, and then I left Berea to take the job over Clay County, Kentucky.
Was that a good move?
Clay for 6 years.
Was that a good move?
I think it was. We ended up actually, and I'm not one of those guys who's a stat rat, I guess. But you know, if you go back and look at it, you know, we had a quarterback there. Actually, we had first 2 years we kind of struggled. It was a major rebuild, and then we were, the last 4 years I was there, we were a really good football team. Actually, I coached a kid who was who's now the offensive coordinator at UVA Wise, and he's actually the all-time leading passer in the state of Kentucky from a yardage standpoint. And he went on to Moorhead and broke all of Phil Simms' records. So anytime you can be around a kid like that, it's
oh, yeah. That's talent, Coach. That's talent. So you coached over at Clay County and everything. Did you ever get in the get close to the state or in when you were coaching, you know, at that school? Hello? Coach? I believe we lost Coach. We sure did. Let's try it again, kids. Just hang with us. Coach, are you there?
Yeah, let's get in. You gotta understand something where we're at here in Kentucky. There ain't no cell. We had to pop this thing in. We got cell signal popped in here tonight.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It sure ain't because of the rain. We ain't had no rain for 29 days. So
okay.
Talk about being hot. Yeah, it's hot down here. If we could be windless, it'd still be hot down here where I'm at because it just won't rain. I don't know what's going on with it.
Coach, when getting back to the show, when you were at Clay County and everything, did you ever make a run and get close to the state?
We were fortunate and unfortunate. We had some, like I said, really good talent. The problem we had was we always ran into two teams in our district that was Bell County and Rockcastle County.
Okay.
And of course, both those teams at that time, if you go back and look historically, I mean, they were competing for state titles and state runners up, and well, we were kind of a rebuild situation at that point.
Was you about one money guy short of really giving them what they wanted?
Well, it's the story of my life, I guess. We, you know, Rockcastle. We played Rockcastle there. Ended up beating us 6 points or 7 points late, last second touchdown, late in the game touchdown to kind of put us in a really bad situation from a playoff standpoint. So, you know, first can always and woulda, coulda, shoulda, but you know, it's always kind of been that way in Kentucky. You got to be real mindful of who you're in the district with, and you know, when you take a job that's a building job or a rebuilding job, and you get stuck in there with two perennial powers, it's going to be a you're going to be climbing uphill, but when you do that, you won't climb uphill with fire in your face.
Yeah, so. So you take the job at Berea and tell the fans you kind of had a little bit of a bad accident that kind of hinders you from being the coach you kind of want to be, and I'm not for sure everything, but kind of take us through. Let's start about June of this year and just running through as we bring us up to now.
Well, I had an accident. I had a little car accident there in July the 12th this year, this summer, and it was actually our third day of practice. And you know, it was a pretty bad deal. I had what's called an acetabular fracture, which basically meant that my hip was not there. I had a dislocation, and it had basically what the equivalent of a crushed hip.
Right.
So they went in there basically in pins and plates and put that thing back together. So I was away for a little bit there and kind of had to turn things over to my assistant coaches. And you know, it was kind of touch and go from a standpoint of, you know, therapy and getting that thing put back
together. And how much time was you spending, let's go back to August, just when – so your coaches are basically doing what we would call two-a-days or just trying to get them basically in shape and ready for that first game. Where are you – are you in PT or what are you trying to do at this point since the wreck was
– No, no. When they let me out, and I say that kind of like I was in prison because that's how I felt. But when they let me out, I was at practice and I didn't miss a practice. I didn't miss any type of team function. But you know, I was in a wheelchair and they'd push me around and you know I would be coaching from a wheelchair. And I say that, of course, I couldn't do nothing physically, but I would direct them and tell them what I wanted to do, and then of course my staff kind of knew exactly what I wanted to do. And but no, I was there once. Like I said, once they released me, I was on the field and did a lot more watching and critiquing than I did, you know, hands-on type stuff. Of course, I couldn't get that wheelchair at that point for quite a while. But that was kind of my August, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I got a 1A team that I talked with, and I did not talk with him tonight, and I wish he'd have been on the show. He said he couldn't talk, and he may be in a freshman or a sophomore. Or he's got a 28-man squad down in Lynchburg, Tennessee, and that's head coach Jason Dobbs, and plays Cornersville and Eagleville and a lot of teams like that around here. And we've got a lot of smaller schools that you can kind of pick and choose from in the 1A level down here. There's a lot of 1A schools in Tennessee. But, take us through, just as far as you're right now, you're sitting at 5-0 and you got a big game Friday night. But as far as trying to build and everything and go into that game, how many guys take the field when you all head out on a Friday night normally?
We're right at 32.
Okay, so you're about like him, 28, 32, yeah. And you're in 1A ball, right?
Yes, sir. We're in Kentucky. We're Class A.
Okay.
Which is, we're one of the bigger, believe it or not, we're one of the bigger Class A schools in Kentucky. I think we're we're sixth or seventh from the top.
Yeah.
As far as number-wise, Class A in Kentucky is a really small class.
I know, I'm with you, and it's hard to find games, and I think I kind of helped you on that Jellicoe game. I knew that, there's a lot of schools just right across that line, as you very well know, and you can find a few 1A schools, right around that, in that area, if you're ever trying to look, and we'll try to help you out if you ever need one. But, when you go into it and you start to try to build, what's some of the first things that you look for is putting the Coach Stepp mentality into it and turning it around? What's kind of, give us a little bit of that recipe and what that looks like.
Well, I mean, the first thing you got to do is look at what's coming back, and I think you got to look at your personnel and see exactly what they did do, what they did well. You look at game film, what they do well, what did they not do well. I'm just not a big believer in, putting a square peg in a round hole. I think you got to, the first order of business, once you kind of look at what you're doing, skill-wise, and what kind of, personnel you got, I think next thing you got to do is what kind of staff you're going to put together.
Yeah.
If somebody hires you and gives you just a little bit of wiggle room to get some assistance in there.
Oh, and I think
and
if Berea gets
assistance to buy into what you're trying to do, I mean, when you're 0-48 or 0-43 or 0-100, the line of assistant coaches that's wanting to apply for a job is pretty short. I mean,
right.
Nobody wants to put that on their resume.
Exactly, and that's just what I was getting ready to say. You're not, as you were saying, they're just not lined up. And you have to prove yourself because, the faculty, staff, administration, you tell them, well, I need this and this and this, and they look at you and say, well, that's not going to be possible. I can't bring those guys in. Because even here, even in our little, you got to have a certain couple of guys that you can hunker down with and it got you back, because you can't be over there, whether it's linemen or backs or quarterbacks or whatever it is that you focus on versus them, you got to be able to turn your back. You can't be coaching them over there and try to coach what's in front of you, Coach.
Well, and that's it. And that is it. I mean, you got to have – and I was telling – we had an interview down here Monday. It was our local radio show, and they were talking about kind of where we're at and some of the things we accomplished this year. And I said, look, we've not done anything other than just – have a formula and try to follow that formula. I said, I've not scored any touchdowns, and I'm not going to. I mean, if you ever watch me run, you understand I ain't scoring on nobody. But what we have done is put together a pretty good staff, and I believe this. If you go look at traditionally good football programs, they got two things, and they've got a good coaching staff as a support staff, and they've got a pretty good offensive and defensive line.
Yep.
And I think if you've got those two components, then you can compete, because you can get a kid coached up on how to catch a ball, and you can get a kid coached up on how to lower his shoulder and find the hole and make his cuts. But the bottom line is there's got to be a hole, and if you can't make a hole, then I don't care. Well, I don't care how – you can be the greatest offensive mind in the world, but if you can't create a hole on the offensive line, or if you can't pass protect for 3 seconds, then, it don't matter how smart you are. It's not going to work out for you.
Well, and a lot of people don't know it, but, people may – there's always been a little snicker about Berea because you're kind of the Stepp little brother. I mean, you're way down the line when you start thinking about Madison County and the hierarchy and everything. But there better not be that much snickering, because I tell you what, all the money, and it's not in the bank. There's a lot of money in Berea, and if that ever gets behind you, and I hope it does, and I hope it really, this can continued success and everybody falls in and kind of helps you out. I was catching some photos of the facilities and everything, and not being mean to everybody, but I mean, just from what I know and where I go, even in the 1A level, you need a little love down there, and they need to. I mean, I'm not being mean, but if I saw any of your faculty, staff, administration, I'd tell them, you know, you got five. If you want to keep that five rolling, you need to dump a little money into this thing and see how far you can take it, and give them a little rope, because you got to have certain equipment and certain things in order to execute and in order to grow, because that's part of attracting talent. You've got a couple of money guys. I saw you play against Caverna, and I felt like you could move the ball down the field pretty good. Seems like to me you got a lot of excitement. You guys are excited and everything. You know, you just got to stay healthy. Isn't that the big thing when you're just in 30 guys? And I mean, how many actually football players you got playing both ways, Coach?
You know, we're probably better than most that are Class A. I mean, we've really been trying to be mindful of the fact that is, you know, attrition is always going to be a factor. And so we've really been, you know, diligent about making substitutions when possible, about
right,
making sure that a lot of kids are getting breaks. And, you know, if you're sitting there and you start looking at scores and you say, okay, at this point, if we can get up two scores, then now's the time to get him a break and get him a couple minutes
right,
here, a couple minutes there. And, well, you know, we've done that, and I think that's kind of paid dividends for what we're trying to do. You know, we don't have the luxury of having 70 or 80, or, you know, in case of, you know, Louisville Trinity's got 125 males in their program. We just don't have that, you know.
And they're all football players, Coach. They handpick them. That isn't something that we just draw them from a public pool, you know, being at the duck pond, picking one up. Everybody that rolls into Trinity and St. X, they're all football players. They all look good to set of shoulder pads.
Well, they go there to play football. I mean, let's just be honest. I mean, they're not, you know, they're like a great academic. That's the thing about us. We offer a great academic. And, you know, kind of a sidebar conversation. We talk about being a little brother. I mean, the trade-off for us is our academics
yep,
is second to nobody in this area. I mean, we're a very academic school. We're kind of a, you know, we're just a small school that we believe in offering our kids the best academic possibilities for free. Now, we're not a private school. Our kids come here, and we do the best we can do to provide them with a top-notch education. And sometimes the athletic end of that does suffer, but our administration, the last administration, we actually had a couple of retirements, and then the current administration, I can't say enough about the commitment that they've made to try and get us caught up. I mean, you look,
thank
the girls
you,
basketball team last year was 22-9.
Mm-hmm.
We're five and oh right now. Our boys basketball team last year, I think, finished up with 18 wins. So, I mean, the commitment's there. They've sunk some money into it. They've
good,
sunk some commitment into it, and that's not going away. And to be honest with you, that's like I was telling the guy the other day, you know, this is not a flash in the pan. This is just a changing of the guard. That's right.
And you got to have,
focused. Like you got the Trinities of the world that they're sitting there, and you know, don't get me wrong, one of my best friends in the world is a DC at Trinity. But you know, the bottom line is that that's what they do. They want you pay to go there, and you pay to play football there. But when you go, you know, you are a football player. And like I said, that's just one example. There's multiple examples in the state of Kentucky. I mean. But the Class A ball is quite a bit different. I mean, you know, to me, I think, and I've been at the 5A level when there was five classes, and I was a 4A school, and we were 4A.
You didn't play Kevin Wallace, did you?
Class A to me is a very, very special place, because you deal with kids that truly, and schools that truly, for the most part, don't have all the, you know, bells and whistles, but what they do have is an unbelievable community commitment and an unbelievable desire to be successful, and that's a pretty special thing.
You know, and you was talking about 5A. You didn't play no Kevin Wallace, did you?
No, I knew better than that. I knew better than that. No,
ooh, you and me both. I tell you what, we may need to talk about that sometime, Coach. I got some.
No, we ain't gonna travel. We don't travel that direction.
I tell you what.
Listen, here's the thing. We didn't. If we wanted to get whipped, we didn't have to go to Bowling Green. We didn't have to go that far. You know.
Well, Coach, you got a big game Friday night. Let's talk about Dayton, and that's up near Northern Kentucky, and. To kind of talk about, so you've gotten a little bit of film. I don't know how you all do it compared to we do it. Down here, we trade two, you last two, and then everybody kind of dips around. If you're real good, they're looking for more, so I'm sure they're shopping or looking, or it's according to how you do it, but take it from there. Talk to us a little bit about Dayton and your next opponent.
Well, we do the same thing. I mean, Kentucky, we trade two for two. And,
okay.
And we like everybody else. I mean, there's always that guy that says, hey, I'll give you a film if you'll give me a
uh-huh.
film. I mean, so you got these libraries of film.
Yep.
You know, Dayton has an explosive – they're kind of – it's kind of weird.
Well, they're good, aren't they? They're the Green Devils, aren't they?
They're the Green Devil. And you know, they've had – it's kind of really odd because they, you know, they fell on hard times. They got a new football coach.
Mm-hmm.
I think they went 0-10 last year. They hired a new football coach. They're sitting at 4-1. They got a kid named Marksberry who was the quarterback last year, who they moved to tailback this year, but he still throws the ball. He still plays receiver. He still runs the ball. I mean, basically, 80% of what they do offense is going to go through him. So, I mean, he has to be dealt with, and if we don't, then I mean, you know, we're going to take our first loss. I mean, that's just how good they are, and how good he is. So,
are they going to run a wing T? Are they going to run a spread? Or is he going to run a beer?
They're a flex bone Army Navy.
Okay.
Option type football team. They're going to get you with some rocket sweeps. They're going to get you with some option game. They're going to get you. They're going to try the best to draw you outside with their motion. They're going to run some inside lead or isolation. We call that. But you know, I mean, Tip, if you watch Army and Navy, that's what you want to see.
Yep.
when you play Dayton.
Yep.
So, you know, and that's a great scheme. It's a great scheme because you got to be disciplined. And if you're not disciplined, then, you know, you're in for a long night.
I tell you what, we got a coach over here. Everybody knows him, but I don't know if you know Kevin Creasy, but most people say it's a single wing tee. I don't say it's that, but he can get into that set or whatever he wants. But if he's rocking and rolling and he's got that brain going, and he can run several different things out of it, but. It is, and you know what? The quarterback is the magician. You just said it, and he's got to be able to run. He's got to be able to pass, and he's just got to be able to dish it, and he's got to be able to hide that football, Coach. He's got to be able to hide it.
Yeah, and what you're dealing with, and call it what you want, but what you're dealing with basically is today's version of the Wildcat. You know,
yep.
You got a kid that can do it all. He can throw, he can run. You know, if he has to, he can still do it. And, you know, you think of some of the kids, you know, of course, from Kentucky. You know, think about Benny Snell last year, what he did for Kentucky. I mean, he was a kid that they could put into multiple roles.
Mm-hmm.
And,
he's
you know,
football
he thrived player. In multiple roles. So that's kind of what you see in you know, a lot of these single wing teams. They're putting their best athlete in that position where he's always going to have the ball in his hands.
Roster-wise, y'all about even? About the same
minute? I mean, yeah. I think they got about 28, and we're at 31. So,
okay. Okay. You know, what kind of defense this guy got?
I mean, they're multiple. They're going to run a little 3-4 look. They're going to run they'll switch up on a little 4-4 look. They want to play with a two high safety look.
Okay.
Their comfort zone and you know, okay. That's my job, and our job is getting out of the comfort zone. The same thing for him. He's going to do his best getting me out of my comfort zone. So
right.
We'll see. Like I said, they do a good job. Their schematics, I mean, they're very active. They're going to fly to the football on a snap. They're doing some good things. You don't go 4-1 and not be doing good things. So I guess that's kind of where you have to begin and end right there. We'll have to see what happens. Whatever happens, happens. Now, the negative is we got to go up there. It's about an hour and 45 minute bus trip.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, are you off next week, Coach?
No. We got Dayton this week, and then we start district play with Kentucky Country Day, who's the number two ranked team.
And that's in Lexington, isn't it?
It's in Louisville.
Yeah, you'll have to go back to. Yeah. Are they coming to you? Or are you going to?
They're coming to us. But
okay.
I say they're number two ranked team, number two ranked Class A team in the state.
Okay.
So, and another thing we got to focus on too is that is a district game that starts district play, and you know we kind of tell our kids, oh, look, we got to deal with Dayton first, and
yeah,
you know don't be looking to something down the road. I mean, that, you know who knows if you. You can't get there unless you take the right steps.
Yep.
And we got to deal with this one at a time. And, you know, we didn't get to be where we're at by looking ahead to opponents. So that's kind of one of the battles we've had to fight this week, too. You know, the kids are in his first district game. And, I mean, Bree has not won a district game since Moses walked the earth. So, we're going to try and change that.
Well, Coach, I'll be watching your scores. I've got a real big one Friday night. We're going to be over Blaze Drive, and I've got a classic on Stork Vision. It'll be Oakland and Blackman, and it will decide second place and first place for region in our play in 6A ball. And then we'll be watching for your scores. We're going to be off next week. So I'll see you. I'll talk to you in about 14 days. But anything else you'd like to say to the faculty, staff, and administration at Brea Community and all the Big Pirate fans? And like you said, hour and 45 minutes, but you expect them to get in those vehicles and go north, don't you?
Well, the only thing you can always say to those people is, you know, you got to conceive it and you got to believe it. And so far we've done that. And, you know, hopefully if they can, and I know it sounds like a cliche, but it is. If we can keep doing what we're doing, then we're going to achieve it. But it takes all the pieces of the puzzle to make it work. So hopefully our fan base and our administration, those guys will keep doing what they've been doing. We'll be fine. Just got to keep on working, man.
Well, Coach, we wish you the best of luck. We hope you stay healthy. That's the most important thing, is to compete and stay healthy and stay away from them penalties and try to keep your money guys in place. And we hope Berea is 7-0 the next time I talk to you. How about that?
Well, that'd be wonderful.
All righty, Coach. I'll talk to you.
Appreciate you.
I'll talk to you then. Good night.
All right. You take care. See you.
Thank you.